Electric circuits and the hydraulic analogy, inductor behavior. An inductor is a magnetic flux storage device. Now you may be wondering, what is magnetic flux and why do you want to store it? We'll get to that. Let's start by looking at the hydraulic analogy. A hydraulic inductor is a water wheel connected through a rigid axle to a heavy stone flywheel. When water flows from left to right, it's directed in a clockwise direction. Here I've drawn the same thing in a cross-section side view. The flywheel momentum is proportional to the flow rate in liters per second. For example, if we have 1 liter per second flowing through, there are 20 momentum units. 2 liters per second, 40 momentum units. 3 liters per second, 60 momentum units, and so on. The momentum is proportional to the flow rate, and the constant of proportionality is called the inductance. For example, here we have 60 momentum units equals the inductance 20 units times 3 liters per second. Now let's take a look at the electronic inductor. A coil of wire wrapped around a cylindrical core. The magnetic flux is proportional to the flow rate in amps. For example, if we have 1 amp flowing through this inductor, we have 20 webers of magnetic flux. If we have 2 amps, 40 webers. 3 amps, 60 webers. The flux is proportional to the current, and the constant of proportionality is called the inductance. For example, here we have 60 webers equals 20 inductance units times 3 amps. The units of inductance are webers per amp, and there's another name for that, Henry's. Henry's means webers per amp. Now, back to the question, what is magnetic flux? It is the number of lines of magnetic field that pierce the cross-sectional area of the core. And there's a mathematical description of that, but I'm not going to get into that. In fact, this definition is too complicated. For our purposes, we can think of magnetic flux as the momentum of an invisible flywheel that tends to keep the same current flowing and resists change. So when you see a picture of lines of magnetic force going through an inductor, use your vivid imagination to visualize a turning flywheel that keeps the current flowing. All right, what about the pressure and changes in flow rate? There is no pressure drop with a constant flow. The pressure will be the same on the two sides when there's a constant flow. There's a pressure drop only when the flow changes. For example, let's connect a pump that maintains a pressure of 20 kilopascals. When we turn on the pump, the flywheel starts turning faster and faster, and over 3 seconds, the flow rate changed from 0 to 3 liters per second. Now, what happens when we reduce the flow? We build up pressure on the other side. That's a negative pressure. Higher pressure on this side than this side is a negative pressure drop, and the momentum of the flywheel becomes less. So we saw before, momentum equals inductance times flow rate. That means the change in momentum is equal to the inductance times the change in flow rate. Now the change in momentum is equal to the pressure applied to the inductor. This notation, df dt, means change in flow rate with a change in time. When I attached the pump here and pumped up the pressure to 20 kilopascals, the flow rate increased at a rate of 1 liter per second per second. When I removed the pump and there was a constant flow rate, there was no pressure drop across here, and the flow rate was constant, no change in the flow rate. When I blocked the flow on this side, there was a buildup of pressure on this side. That's a negative pressure drop from here to here. And the flow rate decreased at 1 liter per second for each second. This is very much like a revolving door. If people are in a hurry, they'll press on the door as they go through and cause the momentum to increase. If they relax and walk through at the same speed that the door is already turning, the momentum of the revolving door stays constant. And if some very slow people go through the door will catch up to them and push them through. That's a negative pressure, and the momentum of the revolving door will decrease. Let's watch it again. Turn on the pump. 1, 2, 3. 3 liters per second. No pressure difference on these two sides and a constant flow rate. And now a negative pressure. A negative drop from here to here, and the flow rate decreased at 1 liter per second per second. Now let's look at the electronic inductor. There's no voltage drop with a constant current. There is a voltage drop only when the current changes. For example, let's insert a battery in this circuit. 1, 2, 3. And now we have 3 amps flowing through this circuit with a zero voltage drop, a constant 3 amps, and a constant 60 Webers. This is like the momentum of a flywheel keeping the flow constant. Now let's put a battery in the reverse direction and apply a negative voltage. 1, 2, 3. We're back to where we started. We saw earlier flux is inductance times current. That means the change in flux with time equals inductance times the change in current with time. The change in flux per unit of time is the voltage applied. You could deduce that from Maxwell's equations. And the notation di dt means the change in current with the change in time. For example, when we applied 20 volts, the current increased at a rate of 1 amp per second. When we remove the battery, there was 0 volts around this loop, and the flow was constant. There was no change in the current. And when we put the battery in backwards, applied a negative voltage, the current decreased by 1 amp per second. Let's watch that again. Go. 1, 2, 3. Constant current. We're at this stage now. 0 volts, zero change. And now let's put the battery in backwards. Go. 1, 2, 3. Okay. A larger device has more inductance. For example, for this hydraulic inductor, if we extend this axle and put another heavy flywheel on, it doubles the inductance. It's twice as hard to get the flywheels moving and twice as hard to stop. Similarly, for the electronic inductor, twice as many windings around the core doubles the inductance. That's twice as hard to develop flux, and twice as hard for the flux to disappear. You may recall from your freshman physics that kinetic energy is proportional to the velocity squared, and so it is with the inductor. The energy stored by this turning flywheel is 1/2 the inductance times the flow rate squared, in this case 10 joules. And for this electronic inductor, the energy stored in this magnetic flux is 1/2 times the inductance times the flow rate squared and 10 joules. So in summary, comparing the hydraulic and electric models, the flow rate is like the current. The momentum of the flywheel is like the magnetic flux of the electric inductor. Inductance has these units in the hydraulic system and Henry's in the electric system. And the energy is in joules. These units in the hydraulic system and these units in the electric system.